In the latest version of NetSupport DNA, our core hardware inventory capabilities have been significantly expanded. In addition to our base Windows support, the latest version includes the ability to capture inventory information from Android, iOS, Apple, Linux, and Windows mobile devices, all of which can then be reflected within our DNA console. As you'll see here, we have a number of Windows 10, Windows 8, Windows 7 devices, but currently there are no Android or iOS devices that have their inventory data within our system. So how do we capture and then add that information into the system? From our hardware inventory menu, we have an option to add computers, and two menus are provided. The first is a simple override option that allows us to manually create an entry on our DNA system for a PC that we are unable to access or deploy a DNA agent onto. But in most cases, we'll use option two, where we can import a standalone inventory from an agent that's been installed on one of our other supported platforms, as explained in the dialogue here. By clicking next, you'll see our option provides us with the ability to import an inventory file that has been gathered by one of our mobile apps. So let's select Add Files, go to our DNA Agent folder, and you'll see we have an option here for an inventory that has been captured from an iPhone 6. We can select that and then continue the process to install our iPhone inventory component. So let's hit Next, and you'll see we can then say Finish. And we now have one unassigned PC that has magically appeared in our hierarchy, which is an Apple iPhone 6. If we jump to our hardware inventory, you'll see I now have that inventory information displayed on my screen. And if I select in my dynamic groups, you'll see it is now available to me. The // indicator beforehand represents that this device is disconnected from the network. In other words, it's a standalone inventory. Now, how did we capture that inventory? Well, if we have a look from the other end on the iPhone and we go to our folder for NetSupport, you'll see we have the DNA Agent app available to us there. If we run the app, you'll see we're presented with a summary that shows us the device identifier, in this case an iPhone 6 Plus, and we have two options. We can either share our inventory information, in which case we will capture inventory and then attach it to an email or a message or similar. We can see here an example where we pop up the option to send it to our Dropbox or other service. Or alternatively, we can simply type in the IP address of the server, if we know it, and we can automatically send our inventory directly to the DNA server for automatic inclusion on the system. Thank you for viewing this tour. Please visit www.netsupportdna.com to find out more, or if appropriate, download a free 30-day trial.